What are some things that just can't be foamed? Let's talk about it. Welcome to Foam University. Today we're going to be talking about some things that just can't be foamed. Before we dive into this, please go below, hit that thumbs up button for us. Thanks. So, first thing we're going to talk about is boats. We get called all the time, people wanting us to insulate boats. A lot of those calls are pontoons. Someone wants us to fill the actual tubes with foam insulation. And I'm here to tell you, this cannot be done. It is not a good idea for many, many reasons. First of all, the foam insulation that we use that's used in construction is not marine grade. Okay, it is not meant to be used as a flotation device, not meant to be used on or in the water. So please, if you're looking for that, that's very, very specific foam and you need to seek that out. Construction grade foam, not what you're looking for. Boats can't be foamed. So the next thing that we're going to be looking at is a couple very specific situations on exterior walls. So the first thing is, if there's existing insulation in there already, that is completely filling the cavity. Now this may throw you off because you may be asking, well, if I have insulation in there already that's filling the cavity, why am I having issues? Well, it could be a couple things. It could be spray foam that was not installed properly, so it's taking up the mass of the cavity, but not properly sealing or insulating the wall. Sprayed in cellulose is also very common for this, also known as glued in cellulose. We get this all the time. There's not really enough room for us to work with, but that is also broken down over the years. Now that cellulose is not performing like it should. The next potential issue for exterior walls is if there is no sheathing, meaning behind the siding, there's no hard board, usually plywood or OSB board. If that's not up, then of course we can't inject foam into it because it will just push the siding out and it will make your home look horrible. And if you're asking, well, I have foam board underneath my siding as sheathing, no you don't. That is not sturdy enough for it to actually hold the foam. So unfortunately, that is another case where it cannot be foamed. So the last thing we're going to talk about is a floor that sits really tight on a slab. So what is wrong with this situation is that the slab is only inches away from the floor and there's no access to effectively insulate that floor space. What you will have is you will have a cold floor, and we get this call all the time. And unfortunately, the only way to effectively insulate it is to cut into the floor around the perimeter of the home. That way you can spray the walls and the joists to seal all that air off. Unless you're open to your house being kind of torn up for a little bit, there is no way to insulate this, unfortunately. And this kind of goes the same way if you have finished off walls on the outside or inside, or a ceiling that's finished off. If you're not open to an invasive process, unfortunately, these probably cannot be foamed. If you want to learn more about some things that can't be foamed, check out the link below. Don't forget, subscribe to our channel and ring that bell to see all of our notifications.